What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is a 2022 Nissan Sentra SV, and I've been driving this car for a couple of days, and I've driven several of its competitors, and what I'm going to do for you right now is give you some things that I really like about this car and some things that I don't necessarily like about this car, and maybe this will help you make an informed decision about your next purchase. The first thing that I really like about this car is the steering wheel. And that may sound kind of weird, but number one, it's the little things in life that make you happy. And number two, think about it. If you're driving this car, you touch the steering wheel every single time you're in it. The steering wheel in this car is very nice. It's leather wrapped, and it also has a flat bottom, which gives it a bit of a sporty feel. Another thing that I really like about the Nissan Sentra SV are the safety features. This car has the emergency braking, it has lane departure warning, and the lane departure warning can shake the steering wheel as opposed to just beeping at you. That's a little bit more of a premium feature that you normally see on higher end cars. And it also has the intelligent cruise control. If you have one of these cars and you want to see a video about how to use the intelligent cruise control, there will be a link in the description for a video that I made about that. A complaint that I have about this car, and it goes along the lines with the safety features, is the blind spot monitoring. Now, it has blind spot monitoring, which is a good thing, but my complaint is the placement of the light. It's inside of the car, on the A-pillar, sort of a little bit further away from the rearview mirror than it should be. I feel like that light should either be integrated into the rearview mirror, or it should be in the housing at least, so that you can kind of see it all with one glance. I've driven a lot of cars with blind spot monitoring, and personally, I think this is the worst setup for the lights that I've seen. It's a small complaint, but a complaint nonetheless. Another standard feature that I really like in the Nissan Sentra is push button start. That comes standard on the SV model. Push button start is a very nice convenience that I have gotten used to. Few of my last cars have had it, and I like it very much. And of course, with push button start, you get the fancy key fob, and you have keyless access. So you can just walk up and enter the car and lock the car while leaving the key in your pocket or your bag. But I do not like the way that you have to interface with that keyless access system. In most cars, when you put your hand in the door handle, that is what unlocks the vehicle, and then you can just pull the door open. But on this Nissan, you have to push the button. It's a little bit of an extra step, and it's not real natural. To unlock the door, pushing the button, I don't like that. You push the same button to lock it, which is fine, but I wish it had the little electrical field inside of the door handle to unlock the car, like most other cars with keyless access do. Now, I have the window sticker for this particular 2022 Nissan Sentra SV right here. And one thing that I absolutely love about this car is it has the all-weather package. For $590, you get dual-zone automatic climate control, heated front seats, a heated steering wheel, and remote engine start. Specifically, the dual zone climate control and the heated steering wheel are two things that are very uncommon at cars of this price point. And if I were going to be getting myself one of these Nissan Sentras, the all-weather package would be a must-have for me. That's a great value. Another thing I like quite a bit about this car is the passenger space. I'm 6'5" and I can sit behind myself, which is nice to be able to do in such a small car. And one more little nice touch, in the back seat, you do have a single USB port for your backseat passengers to charge their mobile devices. It might not seem like much, but it is more than you get from most cars in this class. Another complaint that I have about this Nissan Sentra is the Apple CarPlay. Now, it has Apple CarPlay, but it's not wireless, which I kind of wish it was. It's funny that we've gotten to the point where we're complaining about Apple CarPlay interfaces when it is a standard feature. But this particular car has a weird thing in the infotainment system where it can only be hooked up to so many phones. So if you get into one of these and six people have already plugged their Apple CarPlay into it and you're the seventh, it will not work. You have to go in and delete somebody else's phone to get the interface to function for the Apple CarPlay. That's kind of annoying. Now, around the back of the Sentra, another feature that is phenomenal to be standard on the Sentra SV at this price point is the rear parking sensors and rear automatic braking. That is definitely a premium feature, and in a car at this price point, not something that I normally see as standard equipment. So kudos to Nissan for putting that in. But where Nissan giveth, Nissan taketh away. This car has no LEDs at all in the front lighting. No LED headlights, no LED running lights, nothing. Just standard halogen headlights. They work well enough, but it is a little bit of a disappointment in this day and age. Most cars are getting LEDs as standard, even at this price point. And it is funny because 15 years ago, the Altimas had HIDs as standard, and then everybody was going around stealing the ballasts and the bulbs out of them, so maybe that kind of scared Nissan away from the fancy headlights. Another complaint that I have about the Sentra SV is the parking brake. Now, the Nissan Sentra, to me, is always one of the sportier compact cars in the segment, kind of right in the Honda Civic range, but the parking brake is a decidedly non-sporty foot pedal right out of a 1970s Cadillac. Think of the scene at the end of Goodfellas when Henry Hill's freaking out and he almost rear-ends that car. That's what you get in the Nissan Sentra. It should have at least a handbrake so that you can pull some J-turns, or my personal favorite, the electric parking brake. That is becoming more common these days, and I think that's something Nissan should look into for the next Sentra. Another thing I like about this car is how it drives. The ride is relatively smooth, the handling is good. For a car in this class at this price point, you could do a lot worse as far as driving experience. And in that realm of driving experience, one more thing I like about this car is the transmission. And this may sound strange because famously this has a CVT, a continuously variable transmission, and of course everyone on the internet hates CVTs, but I do not. I like them. I think they're smooth, I think they're fuel efficient, and even though they're not quite as sporty as a manual transmission, unless you're going to get a full-on manual transmission, what really is? So I think the transmission in this car is very good. It's a CVT. I like CVTs. And as far as CVTs goes, it works very well. Don't let that scare you away from a Nissan Sentra. Another thing that I really like about the Nissan Sentra SV is the fuel economy. It's rated up to 39 miles per gallon on the highway, which is very good, but I did a real-world fuel economy test on this car last night, and it did even better than that. I'll put a link to that video in the description below. And more to the point, it handily beat a 2022 Honda Civic Sport that I did a similar video on recently. So the Sentra gets very good fuel economy in my estimation. Final thing that I'll say that I really like about this Nissan Sentra is the value. Again, with the window sticker, the total MSRP on this 2022 model was $22,695. And for that amount of money, despite my complaints about it, it is a fantastic value. I don't know what these things are actually selling for right now in the real world. Of course, the whole car business is topsy-turvy. I don't know how much you have to pay over window, if anything. I suppose it probably depends on where you are in the country and how long you're willing to wait. But if you can buy one of these for close to window sticker right now, I would say that is a great value and I highly recommend it. My apologies for the clickbait. I don't actually really hate anything about this car, but people on the internet love to hate stuff, so I put that in the title. I do appreciate you watching my video. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I'll do the best I can to answer them. Please like my video, subscribe to my channel, and have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.